still watching? Okay. Question. What was the question? John Burry. The question from before that I wanted to answer, but I thought it was too long an answer, was, oh, it was, have has anyone ever published any anything that I've written? I was assuming like writing, like a short story or something. And the answer is no, but I was going to submit a little short story to, not that the New Yorker would ever in a million years print it, but it was a short story about John Lurie, because and John was he's a musician, and they did a in something called the Lounge Lizards, and they did a piece on him about a year ago. Basically, it was called "Where Is John Lurie?" He's basically a recluse who happens to live behind me, and I discovered that because he was the man who single-handedly solved Walkergate. I call it Walkergate because there's this old person's walker that was on the roof of this building behind me that was in my bedroom window for 7 years, and it depressed me every morning, and I just thought about dying and my body disintegrating, and this walker was just the reminder. And I finally asked, this is a long story, but I asked the local coffee shop, the guy that runs this place called Saturdays. He's a very nice guy. And I said, do you happen to know anyone that lives in this building that could help me move this walker? Because it's killing me. I've dealt with it for 7 years. And it's breaking me now. I gotta figure this out. And he said, yeah. And do you know who lives in that building? He said, John Lurie. And anyway, it was this epic moment where I happened to be in this room watching television. And because my cable got fixed and I watch TV now. And there's this light on the roof. See, I told you it was such a long answer. There's this light on the roof that basically, it's very kind of this ominous light on that roof. And when it was John Lurie himself, came up, went to the roof. Like, it looked like he was coming out of some sort of like hole to heaven, and, or gate, it's supposed to be called a gate. And it was like, somehow the light projected his profile on this other building. So he was like this ginormous creature. And I was like, what is that? And I thought actually at first it was some sort of like video, like little project someone was doing, like on a, you know, projecting something on a building. I was like, that's kind of cute. And then I realized it was John Lurie removing the walker that was in my bedroom window. And he saved my ass. He really did. I'm so appreciative. So I was going to write a less convoluted version of that story and submit it to the New Yorker, but I haven't done that yet. So that's the answer to that question. Should we just do another song? Should I bore people? Do you think that was bad answer? Is this okay? One more. What else we got? Can you help me? Ari's going to pick the question. Oh, movie score. Do you think the genius next door writing genius incorrectly was on purpose? No.
If you could collab with anyone, who would it be?
Dolly Parton. Nice. And on that note, we'll sing a song called Carousel. And I play it. Brought to you by Poland Spring and live stream.
Takes so you can put your weapons down. All you'll change the pace of how the days creep up on you. But the goodness is something you don't have to chase, 'cause it's following you, and all you'll hear is the music. Beauty stands before you, and love comes back around again. It's a carousel, my friend. Why?